Nintendo just released the super portable Nintendo Switch Lite for the low cost of $200. Is it worth the purchase over the more expensive original Nintendo Switch? What if you already own the original Nintendo Switch? Should you upgrade then? The short answer is yes. Stay tuned to find out why. Let's first talk about the cost. The Nintendo Switch Lite is selling for $200. I think that this is a good deal since the launch price for the original Nintendo Switch was $300 and it is still selling for that price even today. Even pre-owned Switches are selling for $280. Links are in the description below. I think the lower cost will finally allow cost-conservative fans to enter the market, but what do you sacrifice for this lower cost? One of the things you lose is the ability to dock the Switch to your TV and use it like a console, so you lose the ability to switch your Switch between handheld and console modes. Anyways, for right now, the Switch Lite better function flawlessly as a handheld and it doesn't disappoint. Take the size and weight for example. The Switch Lite is smaller at 3.6 inches high, 8.2 inches wide, and 0.55 inches thick. The original Switch is 4 inches high, 9.4 inches wide, and 0.55 inches thick, and the Switch Lite only weighs 0.61 pounds, where the original Switch weighs 0.88 pounds. Therefore, the Nintendo Switch Lite is 30% lighter than the original Nintendo Switch. So yeah, the Switch Lite is technically more portable, it is smaller in size, easier to pocket, and lighter to carry around. And those three colors look amazing, yellow, gray, and turquoise. But does the reduced size cause ergonomics to take a hit? I don't think so. My average size hands actually find the Switch Lite more comfortable than the original larger Nintendo Switch. I think this is due to two reasons. The first thing is the weight. The Switch Lite, which again is lighter than the original Switch, doesn't strain my wrists and forearms as much during long-term gaming. Additionally, since the Switch Lite is one solid piece instead of three separate pieces like on the original Switch, it just feels more durable and rigid during playing. I don't feel any flex or have to worry about one of the Switch Joy-Cons coming loose during gaming. If you're really worried about ergonomics, third-party manufacturers have made grip cases in the past, and I'm sure they will make them for the Switch Lite as well. Finally, you can hook up a Bluetooth controller to the Switch Lite, but would you really want to do that on such a small screen? Speaking of the screen, Nintendo reduced the size from 6.2 to 5.5 inches. Although the resolution is still 720p, the pixels per inch or PPI has increased from 237 to 267 due to the smaller screen, creating the illusion that games look high resolution. As a result, everything looks super crisp and sharper on the Switch Lite's smaller screen. On the flip side, many reviewers have mixed feelings about this size reduction due to the fact that small text will become even smaller. To me, the reduced screen size is fine, as game developers should be aware of the smaller screen size and increased text size when creating their games. For previously released games, all it takes is a patch to increase game text size, but if you've been struggling already to read small fonts on the current Nintendo Switch in handheld mode, maybe you should hold off on the Switch Lite, as you won't be able to plug it into a TV's big screen. So what else has changed? There are no Joy-Cons that detach from the Switch Lite. The buttons are attached just like the PlayStation Vita. Nintendo also took away Rumble, the IR motion camera, and the kickstand. Therefore, there isn't any vibration during gaming. Games like 1-2 Switch that require IR motion camera aren't supported, and you can't easily prop the Switch Lite on a table and play multiplayer. So what else about the buttons? Nintendo is finally giving us back the D-pad. It feels very premium and I have no complaints. I'm happy that Nintendo heard their users and reintroduced it. Side-scrolling gamers like my wife are thrilled. The rest of the buttons are present and feel just fine. They are very tactile. External game controllers can be connected by either Bluetooth or to the USB-C port using a USB-C to USB-A adapter. Remember though, there isn't a kickstand. The new processor, including the Switch Lite, is more power efficient than the original processor while still providing the same exact performance. Loading times are not affected, FPS isn't affected, resolution isn't affected, and texture quality isn't affected. The only thing that is affected is battery life. Nintendo is claiming the Switch Lite gets 3 to 7 hours of battery on a single charge, depending on what you are doing and what your screen brightness is set to. This looks very good on paper. The portable version of the Switch gets up to 20% more battery than the original Switch. As I said before, this is all thanks to the new lower power processor. The problem is that Nintendo recently started including this new lower power processor in the original Nintendo Switch. You can spot these updated versions easily as they are being sold in red boxes, and their model number is HAC-001-01. The red box Switch's battery life is a whopping 4.9 to 9 hours. For the Switch Lite, Nintendo reduced the lithium-ion battery capacity from 4310 mAh to 3570 mAh to reduce size and weight. Therefore, the Switch Lite has good battery life, it beats the original Nintendo Switch's battery life, but it still isn't the best. Get the latest Redbox Switch model for the best battery life possible, or you can purchase an external battery, see a link in the description below. Regarding the sound quality, the Switch Lite sounds just as good as the original Switch. If you want the best sound though, grab some headphones. I'm happy to say that the Nintendo Switch Lite does include a headphone jack, but Bluetooth headphones are currently not yet supported. So finally, let's talk about compatibility. What can't you play? Well, most games are playable, but any game that requires Joy-Cons to be disconnected isn't supported. Games like Nintendo Labo, 1-2 Switch, and Just Dance are already not supported. You could technically buy some extra Joy-Cons to get these games working, though. Games that require the Switch to be docked to the TV, like Mario Party, are not currently supported at all, regardless of whether or not you have extra Joy-Cons. Nintendo points out game compatibility for the Lite model on the back of the game packaging and on the Nintendo eStore. In conclusion, if you want a cheaper, colorful, and portable Nintendo Switch, one that is built for ergonomics and durability, one that is lighter and smaller than the original Switch, one that has a D-pad and better battery life, then the Nintendo Switch Lite is an awesome choice. Just remember, its battery isn't as good as the latest Redbox Nintendo Switch, it has a smaller screen size, it can't be docked, it lacks IR and rumble, and game compatibility is reduced. Click like if you liked this video, please subscribe and hit the bell icon if you want to see more, and check out dancebesttech.com for a full written review.